Today I'm here with a new video, and today I am doing a mini review. It was a long time since I did this. I have done one mini review before, so I was like, okay, maybe it's time. So I'm going to talk about some mainly face products that I really, really, really like, and also some that I think I like all of these products I'm going to talk about, but I usually don't do like reviews on base products. I only do it on like eyeshadows. So I just wanted to review some of my base products I have, and it's also some mascaras and other eye things that is not eyeshadows. So I think we just get started, and I'm thinking I have two brushes I want to talk about, so maybe I should start with those. And I have talked about both of these brushes, I think, in like favorite videos. But I wanted to review them because I have used them more, I have washed them a couple of times. So, okay, let's start. The first brush is this one. It is a super big powder brush that is from a Swedish brand called Hiccup. And this is the 111 Powder Deluxe. This is the best powder brush I have ever tried. It is so big. I love big powder brushes. I don't get people that have like small powder brushes. It is so soft. It holds the form really good. It's vegan. It's good with both, what is it even called? Pressed powder and with loose powder. This is the best powder brush I've ever tried, and I think all of you should try it because it is amazing. The other brush is from BH Cosmetics. It's their V3 brush. It's a tilted, I never know what to call this. It's chopped off. It is, I use it for contour, for my stick. Contour sticks. What is up with me? My contour sticks I use this with. I have been in the hunt for this for so long. It has been sold out for so long. I think Beauty Bay finally got this again, and I bought it, and I love it. It is so good. I really love, I have tested out three different brushes from their vegan line. This gray one, BH Cosmetics, they are really, really good, and this brush is amazing. So, should I take a face primer? I can take this primer, this foundation, in the same little review. The primer is the Skin Protecting Primer from Kix. That is a Swedish brand. This is kind of cooling, and it is so, it feels so good on the skin. I don't know how much difference it does, but I really like it. And it is in a glass bottle, so it feels a little bit luxurious. It is supposed to help to protect your skin from blue light. I don't know about it, but it feels really good, and it feels so nice to have it on when it is this hot outside and I'm going to use makeup. It sinks into the skin. It feels really, really good. So I've been liking this one, and I've been loving it together with the Stay Naked foundation from Urban Decay. This I bought because of Angelica Lyrmar. She have raved about this foundation, and I finally tried it. And I understand why. I have the color 10NN. This is such a good foundation. I have had it on, was it for like 10 hours, I think? 10, 11 hours, something. And it was so hot that day, and I did clean a little bit at home, and I was just sweaty that day. It held up pretty good. It got away like on my nose, but it's because I touched my nose. Other than that, in the rest of my face, it looked really, really good. So I can really recommend this as well. I have a dry to normal skin type. This feels so good on the skin. It stays really good, and it's maybe a little bit too matte. If I could like choose, I would have it a little bit more luminous, but it is really good, and I can fix that with like a powder or something. What should we take then? Should I take a concealer maybe? I don't think I've talked about this concealer that much, but it's the One Drop Coverage from Catrice. This is so, so good. I have in the shade True Ivory. I think this is the lightest one. Or if they have a white one. I don't know, but this is so good. It is full coverage. I guess it is, but it's not like too much. It's full coverage, but it's still... It's very liquidy and it doesn't dry out and it stays on really good and it feels nothing underneath my eyes. So I really, really have been liking this. This is one of my favorite concealers, actually. It's really, really good. And then I also have a powder. I've talked about this in a favorites videos, I think. And it is the Nabla Close Up Smoothing Pressed Powder. I have in the color Light. This is the best pressed powder I have ever used. I think I'm about to hit pan soon. It looks like that, but it is so, so good. I was so worried that it was going to dry out my face. It did not. I like how my skin looks when I have had this on. It sets the foundation really good. And it's just such an amazing pressed powder. I am going to buy this if I run out of this. And I think I might do that at some point. Because I have never used a pressed powder as much as I've used this one. Okay, I don't know like in which order should I take... I am going to talk about a setting spray now. And I don't know if this is still available or not. I don't know what NYX is doing, but this is the Bare With Me Prime Set Refresh Multitasking Spray. I love this. I used it as a primer, as a refresher, as a setting spray. It is so, so good. It feels amazing on the skin. It smells a little bit, but it is a pleasant smell for once. I like it so much that I have two more bottles, I think. And I think they are taking out some of the products from the Bare With Me series and put in some new things. I don't know, but I don't know if this is still available. But if you find it, I bought it when it was on sale. If you find it, buy it because it is so, so good. Then I have one bronzer, one highlighter and a blush palette. We can start with the bronzer that I use as a contour. It is the Milk Makeup Matte Bronzed in Baked. I have the mini. It looks like this. I have had this. I bought it in December, I think, and I didn't start to use it since like maybe been using it 2 months or something like that. And that is because I've been so afraid that this is going to be too warm and too much for me, but it's really, really good. I like it so much, and especially together with this brush from BH Cosmetics. This is so good. Everybody that has raved about this are right. Maybe I don't love it that much, but it's really good. It works for my pale skin, so it should work for you. And it works so good as a contour shade. And the blush. This is, I think... It might be my favorite blushes of all times. It's the Moon Prism Blush Palette from Luna Beauty. First of all, the packaging is amazing. And these are 6 blushes. I have used all of the blushes except for this Gravity. I think this is too dark for me. I can use this Spacey if I'm going with just a little bit at a time. This, I haven't, like, dared to use it, so if we take out like this. But the other ones are amazing. They are so, so easy to work with. They are so nice. I love this one. I think if I only could keep one blush, I think I would keep this one. That is a good review. I don't know if it's really like that, but... I really, really like this blush palette. If you have had your eyes on this, buy it. It is amazing. And the packaging is so good. I love Luna Beauty's packaging. they are so good with packaging. And the last face thing, I think, yes, it is one highlighter from Nabla, and this is Skin Glazing in Ozone. I have been liking this so much. It looks so good. What I like about Nabla's highlighter, I have three of them. They are really like natural. They give such an amazing glow. You can build it up if you want to, but you can have it like just a hint of an highlight. And I just love this one. It is so good. I'm so happy that I finally bought it. It has been out of stock for so long. It's so good. I know why people rave about it. I also want to rave about it. And then, should we go into the eye stuff? I actually have two mascaras. Who am I? But we can start with an eyeshadow primer. I don't know if I have talked about this so much, but this is like the best eyeshadow primer I have ever used. It is from Milani. It's the eyeshadow primer. This is amazing. I love this. It has worked so good with all shadows I have tested out with. All the shadows has lasted so good with this. I usually have a problem that my eyeshadows crease a lot because I have kind of like oily eyelids. This is amazing. I love this. I am going to buy this over and over and over and over again because this is the best eyeshadow primer I have ever used. Should we go into the mascaras maybe? One is a mascara that I'm going to throw out because I've had it for quite some times, and the other one is new to me and I love it. So the one that I'm going to throw out is the Major Pleasure from Nabla. This is actually really good. The only thing I am not super fond of is the brush. It is like this with big hairs. I don't like this. I like more of a rubbery mascara, but that one is really good. I can't, if it is super warm outside, it starts to lay under my eyes a little bit, like after a couple of hours, so it holds up really good, but sometimes it falls. But the other mascara that I am so impressed by this, and this I bought because Paulina's Beauty has raved and raved and raved about this. It's so cheap and it's amazing. It's the Essence You Better Work. And this I also had on when I had the Urban Decay foundation that sweaty long day. It didn't fall a bit. I am super impressed, and this was so good. It is Yim proof and waterproof. I don't know if it's Yim proof. I will never have mascara when I'm working out, but the brush on this, hello, these are the kind of brushes I like. The only thing I miss a little bit with this, I get length, but I don't get super like volume. I have this on today. Really like it. I'm going to buy it again because it's one of the best mascaras I've ever tried, and the cheapest mascara I've ever tried, I think. Love it. It feels like this turned out to favorite video, because the last thing I'm going to talk about, I am so in love with these. I think these are amazing. It's NYX new Vivid Brights eyeliner in pen form. I only took three of them. These are amazing. It's just, I don't know what to say. I get like color immediately from them, and they last long, and they are just amazing. The color payoff is so good, and I just really like them. I think these are my favorite pens. I don't know, I love my ColourPop, but these are really good, and I can really recommend them. And they are just so easy to have on. You don't have to go in like this all the time. Just flip and they're there. Really like them. I think NYX are really good at doing eye pens. And yeah, that was actually all I wanted to talk about. It felt like it was more like a favorite video than a roundup review thing, but I just like these products so much. Some are maybe just okay. I really like all of them. But yeah, I really hope you like this video, and I don't know what to say. I really hope you like this video, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do, so you don't miss any of my videos, and I hope I'll see you in the next one. Bye!